talk about accolades, high school, All-State, an All-American in college, and a member of a national championship team. Christy, that has to be a wonderful feeling to be able to take that level that you had for all those years and bring it to Division I coaching. How does that all work out? And mentally, how do you prepare every day from the time you were in high school?
Mm-hmm. Seems so long ago, actually. High school All-Stater seems so long ago. But, you know, I was really fortunate to have great coaches my whole career, from my high school and club coach, Deb Graffington, all the way through college, and you know, some of my mentors as an assistant coach. And so I think a lot of my success has been because of the people that I've worked with. And now that I've been through that as a player, you know, playing for 10 plus years, and as a coach, coaching for over, you know, 12, 13, 14 years, I feel like I've had a lot of success at all sorts of levels, whether it was high school, club, college, and I'm able to take all of those experiences and kind of blend them together and take a little bit from each of the coaches that I've worked with and apply it to what I do now. And I love it. I'm having a great time.
Now, Christy has coached at all levels, and that's an exciting part of it, because, you know, being on a national championship team, and then the mentors that you've had of coaches at Wisconsin, and when you were an assistant coach there, how does that relate to your everyday activities as a coach now?
I feel so lucky that I played at an elite level, you know, really the highest level you can play at, and winning a national championship. And when I was at Wisconsin as an assistant, you know, that was the highest level as well. We went to the Elite Eight and the Final Four. And so I feel like I know how the best teams in the country, how they train, how they travel, how they manage their time, how they eat. You know, and I think that's a big part of just knowing what are the best teams in the country doing, and, you know, using those experiences and passing them on to the kids I coach now. So, you know, we travel the same way. We travel at Nebraska and Wisconsin, and we study the same way, and we prepare for matches the same way, and we train in a similar way. So I think that those things that I learned there and those habits that we developed, you know, I apply those exact same things to the team I coach now.
I want to talk about the Midwest is the mecca of volleyball, mm-hmm. Division I now. You know, what you would think would be a West Coast predominant sport, but it's not. Nebraska, national champions last year. As you mentioned, Wisconsin has continually been a perennial power, as well as the Big Ten and the Big 12. Talk about those two conferences and how they relate to each other.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know, actually a lot of people might not know this, but the Big 12 was ranked the toughest volleyball conference in the country last year. And, you know, a lot of people just assumed that UCLA and the Arizona and the Stanford, but actually we were ranked the toughest volleyball conference last year. So it really doesn't get any better than the Big 12 and the Big 10. The athletes in this area, the Midwest athletes, they're so physical. You know, it's not that we're talking about 5'9 good athletes. We're talking about 6'2 athletes that can dunk a basketball. So, you know, the Midwest, the Big 12, the Big 10, it's just an elite level of athlete that's playing volleyball now. And it's a physical conference. You know, these are some of the best athletes in the country in any sport. And, you know, if you do well in this conference, if you're doing well in the Big 12, if you're in the upper half, if you're, you know, third, fourth, fifth place, as well as the Big 10, you're one of the best teams in the country.
Well, and you mentioned multi-sports. Is that the type of athlete you're looking for as a volleyball player? You want them to participate in from a mm-hmm. high school level?
Yeah, I love it when we get multi-sport athletes. You know, I think they're just a little more well-rounded, maybe a little more balanced. But you have to balance that with, of course, experience. You know, it's tough to take someone that's hardly played any volleyball and try to turn them into a great player in 4 years. So, you know, we love players that are doing, playing basketball and maybe track, you know, and doing a couple different sports, but yet still find volleyball as their, you know, that's their first love, and that's that's their passion, and that's their number one sport, and that's the sport they spend the most time in. That's kind of the athletes we're looking for.
Well, Steve and Bill and I and our crew from Iowa Sports Weekly covered the girls all-star high school last year, and what a tremendous amount of athletes that were on that team.
Oh yeah, it's, you know, Iowa, we're rich in athletes. You know, we love recruiting in the state. We obviously want to keep all those Iowa good athletes in Iowa. We want to keep them here. So yeah, we recruit heavily from Iowa. You know, there's great players all over the state, and we'll continue to hit the state hard and try to keep those kids at home.
Well, and it's talking about that, of course, the Cyclones are way up in season attendance since your arrival here. This is your third season. Mm-hmm. So anytime you get a chance to come and see the Cyclones play, make sure and do so, because it's outstanding, it's exciting volleyball.
Absolutely.
And the kids I know that we've talked to today and visited with over the years, recently at the Fan Fest that we had, mm-hmm. The Cyclones,
yep,
had here. How much fun was that for the students to, or the athletes to become a part of the community?
It's a blast. You know, when we do something like the Fan Fest or go out on tour and go around the state and get to meet some of our fans, it's just unbelievable. You know, the support when you have, you know, several hundred people there waiting for the bus to arrive and waiting for your athletes to get off the bus or waiting for the coaches to get off the bus. I mean, what more could you want? You know, we're proud to represent the state of Iowa, and it's a great state. You know, the fans are so loyal and supportive, and especially I feel in the Ames community. You know, we just feel very loved here, and we love it.
Well, congratulations on your success going into your third year, and continued success and back into the NCAA tournament again this year.
Thank you so much.
Christy Johnson, head volleyball coach for the Iowa State Cyclones.